As an award-winning Christian comedian, Chonda Pierce is constantly surrounded by spotlight and laughter.
Hide it under a bushel. No!
Yet in 2004, Chonda was in an unfamiliar place. A cloud of depression took the light and laughter away.
It just seemed like it came out of nowhere. I think depression was an indicator of some things perhaps that I had not dealt with, or a life change that I needed to make that I was not willing to make on my own, that my body finally had to tell me, do this or you're not gonna survive it. And one was to pay more attention to my sleep pattern, not to work so much. To just take on, you know, get disciplined and say, I'll work these amount of dates a month and no more. And I can remember the first time a doctor saying, I believe you're clinically depressed. And I go, well, I believe not. I mean, this is true. I'm a comedian. I don't get depressed, you know, and that's really going to throw a kink in my job.
Can you walk me through the period when you were out of order, physically and emotionally?
You have a conscious effort to hold your head up, where it's not just something you think of to do, but you are consciously going, I've got to snap out of this, or I've been sitting here in this chair for 3 hours. I've got to get moving, you know. And then in the worst stages of depression, I call it despair, you know, for me, I was thoroughly convinced that I don't need to be in this world. And you have these suicidal, frightening thoughts that you never dreamed, especially as a born-again Christian, that you would have.
Chonda's family noticed her suicidal tendencies and checked her into a clinic.
You had to reveal yourself in gut-wrenching, honest tones and words and tell exactly how you felt, not the church version, not that, well, I'm blessed, and then you leave and go to your car and cry. Mm-hmm. You know, you had to tell absolutely the honest truth, and you were in an atmosphere where you could try different medicines until you found one that was working, not working against you, but working to bring you toward healing.
What were some of the things you were feeling around that time?
It became a humbling thing, to tell you the truth. You know, it's one thing to say you rely on God, but yet you're taking medicine. And I used to think, well, then that looks like I'm not relying on God. Well, but see, the opposite can be true. If you're not humble enough to take your medicine and allow God to work in that way, then what you've done is dictate to God how He's supposed to help you. I had to write on that medicine bottle, God is working in ways you may not see, so take your medicine.
Chonda took off work for about 2 months. Her new plan of action helped her regain love for life.
After you came back to work, was it hard to go back on stage?
I had to let my body tell my mind that it was lying to me. In other words, if I went through the step-by-step motion that it takes to either get on an airplane or get on a bus, then somebody'd hand me a microphone, here, put some lipstick on, it's time to, I'd go do my 20 minutes and the crowd would laugh and I could hear them laugh and then I'd go, well, this is crazy, you know. I'd step off the platform and begin to cry. And so was I two-faced? No, I don't think so. What happened for me is I saw the glory of God, because there's no way Chonda by herself could have showed up. This is my job. Mm-hmm. I hope it glorifies God. I'll do my best to, but if I fall flat on my face, He's not gonna care. You know, He's just going to be glad that I get up and try again, you know.
Oh, that's so freeing. Yeah.
It is
freeing. It's making me relax more, you know.
Well, good. Take your shoes off.
Yeah. Give me some of those footies that you have.
Chonda is back doing what she does best. This time, she's armed with a healthy work schedule and a new perspective on life. Closer to home, Chonda works at Branch's Recovery Center. She helped found this center to share the light of Christ during difficult times.
Worship is such a vital part of the healing experience. We want to show you what it's like to worship beyond yourself and just worship the King of Kings, and it is amazing.
How do you feel today after coming through everything you've been through?
You know, today is a good day, and I say that very, very honestly. You have to take it one day at a time. This is the first time in my life I can serve God and love Him and adore Him irregardless of what's going on with me. That it truly is now all about Him.